Say you are good, Jesus. Say you are good, Jesus. Somebody help me sing and say he's good. Come on.
To get ready, no, but you're welcome, Mama Angelica. Good morning to you. Hallelujah again.
Good morning, everybody.
Hallelujah. She was one of the first people to join us in prayer this morning around 4:45. So, you know, and, you know, it's great when I see people joining this early. Hallelujah. I see Sister Stacy all the way from New York as well. Good morning, Sister Stacy.
Good morning, Pastor B. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Sister Stacy.
Good morning. God bless.
And I see Sister Daniela all the way from Maryland. Good morning. She's my neighbor. I miss her so much. Hallelujah.
Sister,
I'll be back soon. Hallelujah.
Okay.
Sister Indira all the way from Colombia, hallelujah, good morning. She's having an awesome time in her new job, and she keeps updating me, and I'm excited to share that on Thursday, all the testimonies that she's having, hallelujah. So good morning to you, you're welcome. I see iPhone 12. I think I can figure out who one of those peoples are, but you're welcome, and God bless you. I know sometimes people like to remain anonymous, but that's okay. So far as you're on here and you're tuned in, you know, that is all that matters. Hallelujah. I see a Zoom user. I'm thinking that is Sister Joyce. Is that Sister Joyce? Hallelujah. Good morning to you. I see Pastor Beatrice as well. Good morning to you, woman of God. It's good to have you this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Okay. All right. I got it. She's currently back in Maryland. Oh, wow. Wow, wow, wow. Hallelujah. Good morning, everyone. I see Pastor Clement joined us as well. Good morning to you, sir. Amen and amen. I'm not getting a good morning. Are you guys up or am I the only one
up? We are up.
Okay, hallelujah. We're going to take one prayer point, please, before I hand over to the man of God and we enter into a time of worship. You know, it's so important. But, you know, I want us to plead the blood of Jesus. You know, we started yesterday, we started praying about the blood and a little bit of the teaching of the blood of Jesus. 1 Peter 1:18 and 19 says, knowing that you and I were not redeemed with what? Corruptible thing, like silver or gold. We were not redeemed by what? Corruptible things. But we were redeemed by the precious blood of Christ as a lamb which is what? Not without blemish. Hallelujah. So we are going to pray, knowing that you and I have been redeemed by the precious blood. We are going to pray and plead the blood upon you ourselves this morning and upon this altar this morning, so that as the word comes this morning, hallelujah, it says what? Then it says, when I see the blood, what will happen? He shall pass over. Hallelujah. The spirit of death, or the spirit of distraction, or the spirit that comes to kill, to steal and destroy, will what? Will not have effect over us. It will be null and void just because of the blood. So I want you to join me this morning as we begin to plead the blood upon yourselves, plead the blood upon the atmosphere where you're calling from. In the name of Jesus, we are taking charge right now in Jesus' name as we prepare our hearts. receive from the Lord in the name of Jesus. Let's begin to plead the blood of Jesus right now. Say, I plead the blood of Jesus upon myself. I plead the blood of Jesus upon my heart. I plead the blood of Jesus upon the atmosphere right now. Upon the place where I am in the name of Jesus. I take fast right now in the name of Jesus. I plead the blood upon my ears. I shall hear the voice of the Lord this morning. We shall hear the word of the Lord, the word in the name of Jesus. It will not just be the man of God's voice, but there shall be an amplifying of the name of the Lord in the name of Jesus' voice. He says, for the Lord will pass through to smite every Egyptian when he seeth the blood. Begin to plead the blood. Say, Father, have your way this morning. It says, then Jesus said to them, most assuredly I say unto you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you have no life in you. We're going to spiritually this morning. Say, the Father, this morning I am drinking and I am eating your flesh. Because it says, and the word became flesh. So as the word comes forth, may the word become flesh in us. Hallelujah. John 6:53. He says, I say unto you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood. I want us in the name of Jesus right now to spiritually say, I am eating the flesh this morning. That flesh is the word of God. Say, I am eating the flesh this morning. Can you join me in prayer, this one prayer? In the name of Jesus, say, I am eating the flesh this morning. And I drink the blood this morning. The flesh, and I drink the blood in the name of Jesus. I am not leaving this altar the same way I came. I am receiving this morning. And let there be life as I eat the flesh, as I drink the blood. Let there be life. Let there be a reaping. Let there be a sharing in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
People of God, I just want to bless everybody for coming. Thank you, woman of God. I just thank God for today's turning point. I believe that somebody's life is about to turn around for good. Hallelujah. And the person that's going to do that is Jesus.
Yes.
Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
Thank you.
He's here right now. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
And he told us this morning, he said he's going to heal bodies. Healing is going to take place in your body as you hear the words of Jesus this morning. Hallelujah. There's going to be resurrection power this morning as you hear the word of Jesus this morning.
Amen.
I want to acknowledge all the men of God, all the women of God from far and wide who are able to tune in. Hallelujah. And all the lovely priests and priestess in the house, Queen of South. Hallelujah. But I just want us to worship Jesus with this song as it goes. Let your room be filled with the presence of God. Let where you are be filled with the presence of God. Let there be an awesome sense of reverence. An awesome sense of reverence wherever you are.
Jesus.
Hallelujah. Just know that if you want Jesus to touch you, then imagine that he's right there with you in your rooms or in your car, and then worship him right here where you are. Hallelujah. We're going to take about 5 minutes to worship him. Amen. Glory.
Oh,
thank you, Jesus.
Jesus.
You are great.
You are great.
Yes, yes, Lord Jesus.
You are great in this house, Jesus.
Yes, when I'm in awesome wonder, come on. Consider all thy words thy hands have made. Yes, I see the stars.
I see the stars.
I see the rolling thunders. I see throughout the power throughout the universe. Wherever you are, let your house be filled with His presence. Yes, 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 yes. Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bande barosentula. Rosendi jaluka pandiba pari brandu zohi. Linde baron zendre bradisa linde brahoi handia. Ando barosi. Linde barosen trobredi carabranja. Linde barosen tahi. Oh my God, thank you, Jesus. Oh, lift up your voice. Thank you, Jesus. Listen, my soul, my soul, Savior, God, how great, Lord, how great, how great. I know you want to worship Him. Go ahead, do it.
Jesus.
Go ahead and do it. I know you feel like bowing down. Lay on your face. Wave hands. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Anybody worthy of worship is Jesus. Come on. Then sing my soul, and my soul, hallelujah, hallelujah. In the river, in the river.
Jesus.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Yes, Lord Jesus. How great, and how great our art. How great our art. Lande baro zendiga. Lende de baro zo. Lende de baro zendere baraba. Lende de baro zendere baraba. Somebody praise Jesus. Somebody praise Him wherever you are.
We salute you, Jesus.
We follow
you.
Brindu garu sendila kaira. How great thou art.
You're great, Jesus.
How great. Mandori baro zondoriga. Dancing. My soul. Lord, we worship. My Savior. Lord, we worship. But we worship you, Jesus. How great. How great. How Sunday, but I'm great. Let there be smoke of His incense. Let it cover your room. Let the smoke of worship cover your room. Let the sweet incense of worship cover your room. Mandiri barozo troli garbarozo. Mandiri barozo. Mandiri barozo dobrini karbarozo te proidi karbarozo.
Father, thank you, Father.
Okay, let me say something before we go on. Hallelujah. Let me say something before we go on. Praise Jesus. You know, those who read the word the most, they are the cleanest in the kingdom. They are the purest in the kingdom. Those who read the Bible the most, they are the purest. Those who evangelize the most, they are the most useful in the kingdom of God. And those who pray the most are the most prayerful. They are the most powerful in the kingdom of God. And those who worship, they are the most loved in the kingdom of God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Somebody following me.
Hallelujah.
I'm going to repeat that again one more time. Now you can fill in the space, whatever you want to fill in the space. Hallelujah. I said the cleanest in the kingdom of God are those who read the Bible the most. They are the purest in the kingdom of God. And the people who are most useful in the kingdom of God are those who evangelize, who are soul winners. And the most powerful people in the kingdom of God are the prayerful people. But the most loved by God are worshipers.
Hallelujah.
I don't know if you really appreciate the love of God for you in August. Just worship Him, take a minute one more time. And make sure that you're not just lost in the cloud, but that you are noticed in the cloud, in the crowd. Hallelujah. That your voice is heard in the crowd. That you're not lost in the crowd and submerged in the crowd, but that you are heard by God, that you also among the numbers, you are worshiping God. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Sometimes you don't even know what to say, but you may just say, Jesus, I love you. I really want to know, I appreciate you, and I want to worship you. Hallelujah. I just want to worship Jesus. I just want to praise Jesus. I just feel like if I could only have more time, I will praise Jesus. Hallelujah. And I will covet nothing else but the presence of Jesus. Hallelujah. In the month of August. Hallelujah. For the remaining of this year, I would rather be nowhere else but by the presence and by the side of Jesus. Hallelujah. And maybe I'm lost for word, just tell him, hallelujah, praise you, amen, glory be to God, wherever you are. Let the smoke cover your room. Let the smoke incense cover your room. Take Jesus. 2 minutes more. Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Jesus. Jesus indeed has been so good to us. If he died for us, yes. If he rose up for us, Jesus. If he suffered for us, he ought to be worshipped. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. I love him so much. I wanted to profess your love for Jesus. Profess your love for him. Profess your love for him. Profess your love for him. Hallelujah.
Lord. Jesus.
We take 1 minute more. Hallelujah. It's turning point. Hallelujah. One minute. Hallelujah. Profess your love for him. I wanted to just sing this song. A glory of your presence. Glory of your presence.
Jesus.
Yes. Tell him I would rather be nowhere else.
Oh, God.
Give your reverence. Come on.
Holy Ghost.
Yes. So arise, O Lord. Rest in me. Rest in me. Rest in me, Jesus. Rest in me, Jesus. And be blessed. By our praise, yes, as we gonna do one last time. Come on. I know you are priests and worshipers. Worship him. Come on. Your presence now fill.
Come to give you praise, Jesus.
Ah,
come to acknowledge.
Hallelujah. As your presence,
Jesus.
Now fills.
Jesus. Jesus.
And your glory,
Jesus,
now fills this place. Hallelujah. Just take 1 minute and just say one or two things to him before you prepare yourself for the word of God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Mende baro centro liga barosa. Mende baro gentili garosa enteri garosa. Do you feel a sense of appreciation at all? Hallelujah. Mende baro shandia. Do you feel like Jesus truly cared for you? Mando bredi karabarosa. You were the only one on the planet Earth who would still have come and died for you. Mando bredi karabarosa. He died like he's dying for only you. Hallelujah. Oh, lover of my soul, lover of my soul, taking me from the narrow clouds, setting my feet upon the rock. Oh, Jesus, Lord of my soul,
you deserve the glory.
From the narrow clouds, setting my feet upon the rock. God, only 5 seconds more. Come on. Put my feet upon the rock. But I want to worship. I am the Lord. I love you, Jesus. We welcome one more time to Turning Point. Hallelujah. We have how many people remember Sarah and Sarine, a twin that blessed us some time ago. Wonderful voices, Sarah and Sarine blessed us some time ago. But guess what? We have another set of twins that want to bless us this morning. Zoe and Bess. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory be to God. Can we put our hands together for the Lord Jesus? Zoe and Grace, God bless us with At the Cross. A song called At the Cross. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
We are blessed by twins. All the way from the studio. All the way from the studio.
Jesus.
There's a place mercy. And there's a place
of grace. Thank you, Lord.
Where all the love I've ever found comes like a flood, comes flowing down. At the cross, at the cross. What?
There's a place, sin and shame.
At the cross, I surrender.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Can we clap, put our hands together for the twins? Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I just want us to take a prayer point before we go on. I just want us to ask that the Lord God, now it is the Holy Spirit that reveals Jesus to us, and it is Jesus that reveals the Father to us. Hallelujah. Now I want us to open to Luke chapter 10, verse 22. By way of starting, Luke chapter 10, verse 22. This is Passion of Christ, part 3. Hallelujah, on turning point. And again, I repeat that as we preach Jesus Christ of Nazareth, there will be miracles taking place in Amen. Your bodies. Hallelujah. We gotta believe it, and we tear every foundation of unbelief into pieces, into shred right now in the name of Jesus. Every foundation of unbelief is torn into shred in the name of Jesus. Now look at this, what he says. He said, all things are delivered to me of my Father, and no man knoweth who the Son is but the Father. Did you see that? Nobody knows Jesus. A lot of us thought we know Jesus. No, we receive Jesus, but the Holy Ghost will begin to identify Jesus to us and reveal Jesus to us. We received him, but he hasn't been revealed to us. And through Passion of Christ, we know Jesus more. Through talking about Jesus, we know Jesus more through the help of the Holy Ghost. And that's why before we go on, just 1 minute, we're going to pray that the Father, which is the Holy Spirit, the Father, the Holy Spirit, to reveal Jesus to us. Because no matter what we preach, no matter what we say, people would not see unless God opens your eyes, like we're saying yesterday, and show you Jesus and reveal his glory to you. And nobody can know God unless Jesus revealed God to us, unless Jesus revealed the Father to us. Hallelujah. You know, some of us know our pastor, which is great. We know our church. We know our Bible. We need to know God. We need to know Jesus. He needs to be revealed to us. Hallelujah. And this is why we are trusting God this morning. As we continue in the series, the God Almighty will reveal himself to us through the help of the Holy Ghost. The Jesus will be revealed to us through the help of the Holy Spirit. Would you just take a minute and say, Father, reveal your Son to me and reveal your Son in me. Hallelujah. Just one simple prayer. Father, reveal your Son to me and reveal your Son in me. Hallelujah. Just one prayer. Just one prayer. That's it. This morning is going to happen.
In the name of
It's gonna happen. Thank you, Jesus. Reveal your Son to me. 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 Monde baro sodobre di carbaruja. Monde di baro. 5 seconds more. 5 seconds more. Cry out. Cry out to him. Let him hear you. Say, reveal your Son to me. 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 Reveal Jesus to me. Jesus to me. Help me to know Jesus more. Nobody knows Jesus and no pain. Nobody knows Jesus and no disappointment. Nobody knows Jesus and no shame. Nobody knows Jesus and no fear. Nobody knows Jesus and no poverty. So reveal Jesus to me. Nobody knows Jesus and no sickness at the same time. It's not possible. You can't know Jesus and no sickness at the same time. Hallelujah. I believe he's going to reveal Jesus to you. I believe he will reveal Jesus to you. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. You know, we try to manage this time as much as we can. And we really believe that God is going to do awesome things. Amen. Now, I wanted to recap on last week real quick. And I wanted to remind us that one of the things we said last week, that sickness and poverty did not come directly from Adam and Eve. And that is such a good news to us. And I'm going to explain the implications of that. Sickness and poverty did not come directly from Adam and Eve. I wanted to say sickness and disease. Sorry, sickness and poverty did not come from Adam. But if I said that, some people will have a real problem with that, because it will require more explanation. So I decided to say directly. I added the word directly to make life easier. Hallelujah. Because if sickness came from Adam and Eve, then everybody in the world will be sick always at the same time. Nobody will ever be well. But there are people who are well, and there are people who have never even been sick before. But also, poverty did not come from Adam and Eve, because if poverty came from Adam and Eve, then everybody will be poor. Every single person will be poor. The only thing that came from Adam and Eve is death. That is why we all die. All of us dies. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 22. Let's take a look at that scripture. I'm just going to look about five scriptures before we close. 1 Corinthians 15, 22. The reason we all die is because Adam died. Adam brought death. So we all die. Every single person died, but not every single person is poor. Not every single person is sick. So you can see what I mean when I said sickness came, diseases and sickness did not come from Adam. It came from somewhere else. And that's what I want to talk about this morning in part three of Turning Point. Hallelujah. But I'm saying death came from Adam and Eve. So Jesus came to deal with what Adam caused. He also came to deal with sickness and death, that sickness and disease that Adam did not cause. Adam did not cause poverty. As a matter of fact, Adam was never poor. As a matter of fact, Adam was never sick. But Adam died. And that is why every single man must die. Hallelujah. That is born in Adam. Somebody follow me. So I wanted to look at this scripture. What did he say? For as in Adam, all die. As in Adam, all die. Now notice, he did not say in Adam, all poor. He did not say in Adam, all sick. But he said in Adam, all die. That's a very good point. But Adam was never sick. I proved that in part one. He was never broke. I proved that in part one. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So you don't have to be broke, because a lot of people say, you know, we are all going to be broke because Adam make us broke. We are all born poor. No. We all going to be sick because Adam brought sickness to the world. No. Adam didn't bring sickness to the world. Adam didn't bring poverty to the world. But Adam brought death. But death is like a tree. And you can pluck sickness out of it if you choose to. You can pluck poverty from it if you choose to. And though the man brought the tree, but he did not ask you to pluck poverty from it. He did not ask you to pluck sickness from it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because the Bible says in Genesis chapter 2, verse 17, the day you eat this fruit, you will die.
Messiah.
The day you eat this fruit, you will die. It did not say the day you eat this fruit. Thank you for the scripture. It did not say the day you eat this fruit, you will be sick, Adam. So Adam was never sick, though he died, but was never sick. Because, and all of us are born into that death. But all of us don't have to be sick. And all of us don't have to be broke. That is why Bill Gates, who is not born again, he's never broke in his life. He doesn't know poverty in his life.
Hallelujah.
You know, I met a family right here in Maryland that they have four kids. Each of the kids have their own personal driver. Mm-hmm. Their father is a multi-billionaire. Mm-hmm. And I used to say, this kid never know poverty in their life, and they will never know poverty in their life. Mm-hmm. I used to think of the kids like that. I'm telling you, the kids are grown now. They're like 12, 17 now. I mean, 12, 13 now. I knew them when they were like 3-4 years old. Mm-hmm. And they already have personal driver at the age of 4.
Mm-hmm.
Each one of them had their own driver, and each one of them had their own nannies.
Mm-hmm.
And I used to say, wow, these kids would never even have a clue what it means to ride a public bus. Are you following me? But if it was true that poverty came from Adam, those children came from Adam, they should be poor too. Mm. But no, we're in poor. Mm. Hallelujah. Amen. But I also said in the last series, I said that Jesus' punishment is two punishments, or are two punishments, but we seem to focus on the last one. Jesus' punishment is corporal punishment and capital punishment. Why is it that we focus only on the capital punishment? Capital punishment means death. Corporal punishment means body injuries. So Jesus suffered body injuries as capital punishment. Corporal punishment number one, and he suffered capital punishment as punishment number two. Capital punishment is punishment on the cross. Can you help us meet the line? God bless. Capital punishment is punishment on the cross when he died for you. But corporal punishment, he didn't die for you. Now, if Jesus Christ did not die, he solved certain problem. He solved the problem that Adam did not cause. The only time that Jesus dealt with the problem Adam caused is when he died. So please take a look, take a particular notice of what I'm saying right now, because I've just spent a lot of time saying that Adam brought death, but Adam didn't bring sickness, and Adam didn't bring poverty. So for Jesus to deal with poverty and sickness, he did not need to die on the cross. Because sickness and poverty came from somewhere else, indirectly. So for him to deal with poverty and sickness, Jesus did not need to die. So he needed to suffer body injury for him to deal with sickness and poverty. But for him to deal with death, which Adam brought, he needed to die. Because the corporal punishment, which is the body injury, deals with the consequences of sin. But the capital punishment, which is the death on the cross, deal with sin itself. Oh, is somebody following me?
Yes.
Look, I'm going to repeat myself. You see, I'm not rushing today. I'm taking my time. And that's okay. Even if we spend 15, 20 minutes more repeating ourselves. Because listen to me, if you understand the things that I'm sharing, by the time I am done sharing it, when you look for the disease in your body, you wouldn't find it anymore.
Hallelujah.
Because Jesus did not die for us to write songs about the cross. Jesus did not die for us to write movies about the cross. Jesus did not die for us to write books about the cross. He died so that you and I should not have sickness and disease again.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
There have been so many books about Jesus' death. There have been so many movies about Jesus' sickness, Jesus' body injuries, which is what we call flagellation, which is what we call scourging. But people are still sick in hospitals, and Christians are still broke. Somebody follow me? And that is why I'm saying this August and this 2022, it is time you begin to face the reality of the work of Jesus on the cross and quit being emotional when you watch the movie, or quit thinking it's about Easter, but begin to think, this is what Jesus did for me. This is my blood that was shed for you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh, glory. Libaro se dentro bredi carbaduja. Body injury deal with the consequences of sin, which is poverty and sickness. But dealing with the consequences of sin is not the same as dealing with sin. Because when you commit sin, three things will happen. Number one, death will come to your life. Because the Bible says the wages of sin is death. Romans 6, 23. But apart from death, and I will define death in a minute, okay? We defined it last week. We're going to repeat it this week. Hallelujah. So amen. When somebody commits sin, three things will happen. Three things happen when we commit sin. Number one, death will come. I will define death in a minute. Number two, there will be punishment for that sin.
Messiah, bah.
Is somebody following me? The punishment is what we call sickness and diseases and poverty. Number three, there will be defilement. You become defiled. And I will explain the defile. Let me quickly explain the defile. Have you ever seen sometime when they say that the reason something is not happening to you, the reason you are not attracting good things is because you have a bad luck around your life? People, unbelievers, use the word bad luck.
Yes.
And they will say, go for cleansing.
Cleansing.
Because you have committed abortion. You have lied. You have drawn false witnesses. You have stolen. And it's bringing bad luck to your life. That's why you can't marry. And that's just why these things are happening in your life like this. That's why you can't get a job. You need to be cleansed. They are not saying you need to be forgiven. They are saying you need to be cleansed. There are two things. You need to be forgiven and you need to be cleansed. There are two different things. The Bible says God is able to forgive us and also cleanse us. Because if God forgives you, he doesn't cleanse you, it's not enough. Forgiveness deals with punishment so that you will not be punished. But cleansing means that your glory is lost and you need to receive your glory back. Oh, is somebody following me this morning? Yes. There are three things that happen when we commit sin. Number one, death will come to our life. I will define death in a minute. Hallelujah. Number two, there will be punishment for our sins. And that's why we need forgiveness for our sins. But apart from those two things, there will be another thing. Our glory will be lost, which means we are defiled. Which means if we're looking for a job, we begin to struggle. When we're looking for a husband or wife, we begin to struggle. Everything becomes struggle. Because we are defiled. We have become unclean. And we can no longer attract good things to our lives. Now, when you look at the cross, these are the things that Jesus Christ came to do on the cross. That's what the Bible says. Almost all items of the tabernacle is sprinkled by the blood, for nothing can be purged but by the blood of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You didn't follow me. So now let me repeat again. The corporal punishment, which is the body injury, deals with the cleansing part and the punishment. But it did not deal with death. So that is why every place they talk about sickness and poverty, they don't mention death. The Bible says he became poor so that we may be what?
Rich.
Thank you. Can we repeat it? He became poor so that we may be what?
Rich.
He did not say he died so we can be rich. No, he said he became poor. So we can be rich. It didn't say anything about death. So through the suffering of Christ, which is the scourging, flagellations, or that you will call corporal punishments, Jesus dealt with poverty and he dealt with sickness and diseases. He didn't need to die to deal with your sickness and disease. All he needs to do is to suffer. Hallelujah. Thank you so much. Look at that scripture. For you know the grace of God, of our Lord Jesus, that though he was rich,
yet
for your sake he died. Is that what he said? He became poor. His poverty is what gave you riches. Bearing the punishment is what gave you healing. It is his death that delivered you from death. Is somebody following me?
Yeah.
You notice that in that scripture there is no death written there. No death. Because I'm making a point. This is all about the corporal punishment. He's talking about Paul, the corporal punishment. For we know that the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, that though he was rich, yet for your sake he became poor. That you through his poverty might be rich.
Hallelujah.
You're going to read all the scriptures here. It's talking about financial riches and all kinds of riches. Which means as far as God is concerned, through the pain of Jesus Christ, through the punishment of Jesus Christ, he became poor so that you and I can be rich.
Hallelujah.
And again, I repeat that this thing has nothing to do with Adam and Eve, what you are reading right here. Adam brought the tree of death. Somebody went to pluck sickness from it, and somebody went to pluck disease from it. So Adam has nothing to do with that. But Jesus said, that is okay. I will deal with the consequences of your sin. And when I'm done dealing with the consequences of your sin, then I will deal with sin itself. You follow me?
Hallelujah.
See, there are two times Jesus was pointing. The first time, Pilate took Jesus into judgment hall. He beat the heck out of Jesus. They mocked him. They laughed at him. They spit on him. And after beating him with blood all over his body, by 40 stripes less than one, with that first punishment, he has dealt with your sickness, your poverty, and all of that. Then Pilate brought Jesus out and said, look at the man. Behold the man. I have beaten him. I have punished him. I have tortured him. Now let him go.
I see.
But they weren't satisfied. So Jesus Christ, see, all the things you're seeing right now, this is the first, what we call the corporal punishment that he suffered. This has nothing to do with your sin, but this has to do with the consequences of our sins, the consequences of poverty. And that is why they call it flagellation, they call it scourging. Praise God. Hallelujah. Now, after this time, they weren't satisfied and they took him to the cross. And then they dealt with him the second time on the cross. And I'm saying that the death of Jesus on the cross is what dealt with death in your life. Because when you commit sin, three things happen. Death will come to you. Punishment will come to you. Defilement will come to you. But through the death, through the suffering of Jesus, he dealt with punishments. It dealt with poverty, it dealt with sickness. Hallelujah. Now, let me quickly define, what does death mean? I mentioned last week what death means. D, what does D stand for in death? D, I mentioned that D-A-A-T-H stand for the spectrum of death. That through those words, the Holy Ghost gave me this understanding for the people of God. That if I can explain D-E-A-T-H for the they will understand what death means. Hallelujah. So let's quickly go through it. What does D mean? D means decrease.
D means
to decay.
Oh, decay.
Or decadence. So what Jesus, what God meant is that the day you eat this fruit, you will begin to decrease. It means to be weak. Now this is why I mentioned last week, Hebrew 1:19, the Hebrew women were strong. Hebrews chapter 11, verse 32, verse 33, the Bible says, out of weakness, they became strong. Out of weakness, they became strong. We were all weak. But when we become born again, we become strong. That's what the Bible says in Ephesians. Finally, brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might.
Hallelujah.
An unbeliever is weak. An unbeliever woman is weak. An unbeliever man is weak. Because the Lord told Adam and Eve, the day you eat this fruit, you will be weak. You will become weak. That's what the D means. Decrease. Weaker and weaker and weaker. Decreasing and decreasing and decreasing. The E means inscripted. Inscripted E, which means the secret will be hidden from you. The day you eat the fruit, the secrets of life will be hidden from you. The divine secret will be hidden from you. Revelations will be hidden from you. That is why in 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 3, the Bible says, if our gospel is hidden, is it hidden for those who are lost?
Hallelujah.
Let me tell you, God revealed divine health to us. To them, God covered divine health. They don't see what divine health is. You see that? What did he say? But if our gospel is hidden, it is hidden to them that are lost. Adam, the day you eat this fruit, something will be hidden from you. The truth will be hidden from you. Secrets will be hidden from you. Divine revelations will be hidden from you. What does A mean? A, what does it mean? B-E-A. It means vulnerable, which stands for assailable. A stands for assailable, which means you are vulnerable, which means you can be attacked, which means you are not protected. What God is telling Adam is that the day you eat this fruit, you become vulnerable, you become open to attack from the devil. That's why the book of Genesis chapter 4 verse 14 says, he said, Cain said, God, anybody that sees me want to kill me. God said, that's true. You are vulnerable. You are open to attack. You see why unbelievers get charms? Thank you. I want to let us quickly read that. Thank you. Behold, thou hast driven me out of what? This day from the face of the earth, and from thy face shall I be hidden. You see, hidden. And I shall be a fugitive and a vagabond in the earth. And it shall come to pass that everyone that findeth me shall slay me. An unbeliever is always afraid of somebody killing them. A witch killing them. A sorcerer killing them.
Wow.
But when you are in Christ, the Bible says, as the mountains surround Jerusalem, so you are surrounded by the angels of God.
Hallelujah.
And the Bible says, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. The Bible says, 1,000 shall fall to your left and 1,000 to your right, but none shall happen to you. But if you are an unbeliever, you are vulnerable, that scripture doesn't apply to you. You are open to attack. The Bible says our life is hidden in Christ, and Christ is hidden in God. Greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. If God be against me, who can be? If God be for me, who can be against me? But they will come in one way, but seven ways shall they flee.
Hallelujah.
But temptation shall rise in as a flood, but God will raise a standard against it. There is no enchantment or divination against Israel and Jacob. Is somebody follow me? Because God was telling Adam, if you eat the fruit, that day you become vulnerable. You become open to attack. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
What does the T stand for? The T stand for terminal, which means the day you eat the fruit, your life can no longer continue again. You're going to have a lifespan. You become mortal. That means terminal. That's what it is, stuff. You become terminal, which means you become mortal.
Mm.
You become something that can die.
Mm.
No matter how long you live, you won't hear, you will die.
Mm.
You know, the way God created Adam and Eve before, let me give you an idea, is that when they grow old in age, they just decide they want to go to heaven.
Mm.
They don't die. They just say, you know what? I'm tired of this, but let me just go to heaven. They just go to heaven. Just like Enoch. The Bible says Enoch walked with God and he went to heaven straight.
Mm.
But God said, but Adam, if you ate this fruit, that's not going to happen anymore. You're going to be dying. Death is going to be coming for you. This is the best that Jesus came to deal with.
Hallelujah.
Finally, H. What does H stand for? H stand for human. You will become human, Adam, the day you eat this fruit. You become ordinary. Human means ordinary. Empty shell without God. That's human. But when God is inside human, you become superhuman. You become supernatural. So he's saying the day you eat this fruit, you become ordinary, Adam. You become an empty shell that I cannot dwell inside you. That's what the H means. You become human. And that is why when you're reading the book of Judges 16:17, Samson said, the day I shave my hair, I become weak like ordinary man. You no longer have the anointing that can break the yoke. You no longer have the fortification of God inside you. You know, do you know when they look at Jesus, they say, what manner of man is this? Because they are looking at a man, but it doesn't look like them. This guy is a man like us. Come, he has so much power like this. What they didn't understand is that this one is a different kind of man. And that they were from Adam. Because the Bible says in Adam, all of us died in Adam. In other words, all of us became weak. Terminal, human, vulnerable, assailable, thank you, inscripted, decrees and decaying, all of us. But guess what the Bible says in John chapter 10 verse 10, the Bible says through the death of Jesus, the Bible says Jesus came to deal with death. The Bible says, he said, can we open to John chapter 10, verse 10? It's a scripture we already know properly. Hallelujah. Thank you. The thief cometh not but for to steal, but for to steal and to kill and to destroy. But I am come that they might have life.
Hallelujah.
And that they might have it more abundantly. Do you notice that? He said, we didn't have life. But he came that we may have life. That death that I've just described right now. He said he came that we may have life. Hallelujah. But the reason we are sick, the reason we are broke, it's not because of all this running around that people do. There is a transaction that's taking place before you are ever here that engender these situations in our lives. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So the day you eat this fruit, DEATH will happen in your life. And that is why I say when we commit sin, three things happen. One is death, the second one is punishment, and the third one is defilement. And through the death of Jesus on the cross of Calvary, he overcame death. Hallelujah. Let me say one thing before I close. I want you to turn with me to the popular scripture that we all know, Isaiah 53, verse 3. Isaiah 53, let's read from verse 3. Isaiah 53 from verse 3. Hallelujah. Is somebody following me? Somebody getting the revelation. Hallelujah. Somebody getting the revelation. Hallelujah. I will emphasize that in the next meeting. I want you to notice, as you read the scripture, you will not find death in it. He is despised and rejected of men, a man of sorrows, and acquainted with what? Grief, not death, but grief. And we hid as it were our faces from him. He was despised and we esteemed him not. Can we read further? Can we read further? Surely, watch this now. He had borne our griefs and carried our sorrows. Yet we did esteem him stricken, smitten of God, and afflicted. No death. Can we read further? Last part. But he was wounded for our transgression. He was bruised for our iniquity. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. By his stripe, not his death. By his stripe, not his death. We are healed. Now, the stripe here is the first punishment. That's what we are calling flagellation. That's what we're calling scourging. That is what Pilate did to him the first time. They beat him with stripes. And by beating him with stripes, he dealt with the consequences of sin. But he didn't deal with sin. He dealt with the consequences of sin. He did not deal with sin. But he dealt with the result of sin in our life, which is poverty and sickness and disease. That is the result of sin. That's not sin, but that is the result of sin in our lives. And by his suffering, the first corporal punishment, by his passion, the pain, the mockery, the slashes, the stripes, he suffered that for us. Hallelujah. And that's why every place they mention poverty in the Bible and every place they mention sickness, you're not going to see death. He was wounded for our transgression. He was bruised for our iniquity. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripe we are healed. And I want you to notice this. There are two men that Jesus did a work for. Jesus did not die for Christians. Now I want to throw people off right now. I really want to throw people off. And so be careful, because I'm about to throw you off. Jesus did not forgive you your sins. He did not die for your sins. He did not forgive your sin, and he didn't die for your sins. The man that Jesus died for and the man that Jesus forgave his sin, that man died long time ago.
Amen.
Oh, what? See? Yes. I told you I'm about to throw you off, and I'm going to throw you off on this point. Hallelujah. Listen to me. There are two people that Jesus died for. The corporal punishment applied to the first person. And the second punishment applied to the first person. The second person, which is the new man in Christ, has nothing to do with the death, with the punishment of Jesus. Let me repeat myself, brethren, so you can follow me. The man that Jesus died for and the man that Jesus forgave his sin, that man later died, and he died long time ago. And that man is not you, because you have been raised with Jesus Christ. And this you that I'm talking to right now, you have never committed a sin in your life.
Hallelujah.
And you cannot be sick. So there's no sickness that can be there. You cannot be sick, and you cannot commit a sin.
Amen.
Because you're a new man in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
Okay, let us help some people right now. Praise Jesus. You know, if you bought a house, the house is a little town house, and you want to build a mansion in that place. You didn't own the land. You didn't own the house. What are you going to do first? You're going to buy the house first and buy the land. And after buying the house and the land, what are you going to do? You're going to destroy the land. I said, destroy the house upon that property, right? That property upon which this that's upon the land. And you're going to erect a new building upon that land. That's what happened. Jesus, when he forgave your sin, he know he didn't need you the way you are. When he died for you, he knows that this man I died for, I'm going to kill him and raise him again. Oh, It's quiet now. Please listen to me, brethren. Praise Jesus. Praise Jesus, because we only have 1 minute more. Hallelujah. So Jesus bought you from, he bought you, he redeemed you. After he redeemed you, he took you to the cross. The first punishment was to redeem you. The second punishment was to kill you. And the resurrection was to raise you up. Hallelujah. I don't know if somebody following me.
Hallelujah.
I don't think you're following me. You bought a building. You bought a building. Come on. You pay for the building, you pay for the land, you pay for the property, but you destroy the whole property because you don't need that building. You want to build a new building.
Amen.
So that property that was destroyed is the old man in Christ. Sorry, old man in the world. Old man in Adam. That man is the one that committed all the sin that Jesus died for. That man is the one that is sick. That man is the one that is broke. And that man is no good. But Jesus couldn't do anything until he bought the man, until he redeemed the man. And after redeeming the man, he took the man to the cross. And he and the man died. Because the Bible says we died with him. And then we were buried with him. And then we resurrected with him. Hallelujah.
Yes, hallelujah.
Jesus.
For me. For glory be to God. And so this man that resurrected with him now has never committed sin in his life.
Amen.
So there is nothing to forgive. This man that resurrects with him now can never be sick. So there is no healing to heal. This man that resurrects with him now can never be broke. So you can never make him rich. He's born rich.
Amen.
Why? Because the old man, that's what the Bible says, that if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. He has never existed before. He has never been known before. He has never committed any sin in his life. He cannot commit sin. He cannot be sick. He cannot be broke. Jesus didn't die for him. Jesus didn't forgive him his sin. He's a new creature in Christ Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
The man that Jesus forgave, the man that Jesus healed, that man died on the cross long time ago. And why did he die on the cross? Because Jesus said, I must go to the cross so I can kill you. Because this you, you are weak. This you are broke. This you can't make it in life. I need to kill you and I need to raise you up again. Hallelujah. Therefore, we are, go back to the same place, man of God. Yeah, thank you. Therefore, listen to that. We are buried with him.
Hallelujah.
By baptism unto his death. That like as Christ was raised up from the dead, by the glory of the Father, even so, brethren, you also should walk in the newness of your new life in Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hey, is somebody following me?
Yes.
Is somebody following me right here?
Hallelujah.
Therefore, we were buried with him. Why was he buried? Why were we crucified? Have you ever read Galatians 2? Can we read Galatians 2:22 right now? I'm crucified with the Lord Jesus Christ, nevertheless I live. I'm crucified with the Lord Jesus Christ. Nevertheless, I live. And I'll close with that. Brethren, we're going to continue. We're just getting into the passion of Christ to begin to understand the mystery of what happened to you on the cross of Calvary. Look at that. Galatians chapter 2, verse 20. Okay, hold on before you go to Galatians. Look at this. Knowing this, that our old man, that's the man I'm talking about, is crucified with him. That man died with him a long time ago. Somebody said the old me died a long time ago. Say louder with your voice. Say
the old me died a long time ago.
Say therefore poverty died a long time ago.
Poverty died
a long time ago. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I don't know. Sometimes it sounds so weak. I don't know why we do that. But the body of sin might be destroyed. So you see what I'm talking about? Jesus said, look at me. I bought you. I redeemed you, but I just want to kill you. I said, God, why did you redeem me to kill me? Why did you buy me to kill me? Why did you save me to kill me? Because he said, this body you have is an Adam. It's the Adamic body. I don't need it. I want to give you a new body that cannot be sick. I want to give you a new body that cannot be broke. I want to give you a new body that cannot commit sin. Therefore, I must crucify you with me. So that is why Jesus went to the cross, the second punishment, which you call the capital punishment, knowing this, that our old man is crucified with him. So not only Jesus died on that cross, you died with Jesus on that cross.
Yes.
Body of sin, this body destroyed by sin, might be destroyed. That henceforth, we should no longer serve sin. One more scripture, Galatians 2:20, and I'll close with that, brethren. I'll close with that. But I'm telling you, as you listen to me and hearing the voice, my voice, as I'm preaching the gospel to you and the good news of our Lord Jesus Christ, your body that is riddled with sin and riddled with sickness and disease will be freed from in this moment, Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Because the devil don't want you to know this truth, to think that you are the same old man, but you are no longer the same old man. Tell the devil that man died long time ago.
Because
he died Jesus Christ.
Long.
Somebody follow me. Galatians chapter 2, verse 20. Look at this. This is another mind testimony right now we're about to read, and I want you to close this morning with this testimony by yourself.
Lord,
I am crucified with Christ. Hold on, brother. I want that to sink as we close. I am crucified with Christ.
I am crucified with Christ.
You see that? Nevertheless, I live, yet not I. That man, no, it's no longer that man, but Christ liveth in me. And the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by the faith of the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me. You see, when he took your life away, he gave you his life instead. And somebody said, but Pastor Mark, how can I enjoy that healing in my body of this new man? This is what you're looking at right now. All you need to do is to believe this thing and confess this thing, and fibroid and cancer and all diseases. Even if you are blind on this line, you're listening to me, blind eyes should be open. Even if you're deaf and you're listening to me, deaf ear will pop out. If you believe what I'm teaching, what I'm saying this morning, somebody repeat, I am crucified with Christ. Hallelujah. Nevertheless, I live. Hallelujah.
But the life I live now, I live in the Lord Jesus Christ. I now live in the flesh.
You love me and die for me. I want you to reject the old man right now. Reject the old man.
So we reject the old man.
Claim your new body right now. Claim your new body right now. Claim your new body right now. We only have 20 minutes before we close. Claim your new body. It doesn't matter what the doctor says right now. Information I've just given you is more than the doctors. The information I give is more than the nurses could tell you. Crucified with the Lord Jesus Christ. Come on, say it. Your doctor, I'm crucified with the Lord Jesus Christ. Tell your body, I'm crucified with the Lord Jesus Christ. The body of sickness might be destroyed. Here, make confession. 1 minute more. Hallelujah. Right now, I declare, let every sickness, every family die.
Every disease,
let every thing fly out of your body right now. My eyes be open in the name of Jesus. Let them pop out in the name of Jesus. Let demons in your body leave your body now in the name of Jesus. Because by his stripes you were healed.
Yes.
And yet the man that was healed, that man died on the cross.
He's
a new man in Christ Jesus.
Yes. I am a new man.
I am super new. 1 minute, 1 minute, 1 minute.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. 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 Listen. We are going to continue this tomorrow. Do you want to hear more? I am hungry for more. Do you want more? Hallelujah. We're going to continue this tomorrow. Pastor Mark is going to continue.
I'll be there tomorrow.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Miss Angelica. Thank you, Miss Angelica. So tomorrow morning, we are going to continue with this. We're going to flow. We're going to go with the flow. Hallelujah. 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 Is somebody blessed this morning?
Yes.
Is
somebody
blessed? No, all blessed.
You are not supposed to be.
I am blessed.
You are blessed.
I am blessed.
You are alive this morning.
Yes.
Because you have been crucified with Christ.
Thank
it
you
says you
God.
No longer live, but Christ that lives in
me.
That
Amen.
Life is in your body.
Yes.
You live by faith. Mm. Christ, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I'm just shaking. I don't know what to say. Thank you so much, man of God, for availing yourself. That's revelation right there. I pray in the name of Jesus, and I lift every soul right now. And I say, Spirit of the living God, let life, let this begin to take root. He says, we shall eat the flesh. We shall drink the blood, and this is it, in the name of Jesus. Let us come alive, even
thank
as we hear
Lord.
This revelation, as these mysteries are being revealed unto us. May we come alive in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
May all the scales come off. May our eyes be opened.
Amen.
Eyes be opened. Say, my eyes are opened. I want
my
you to declare them
open. My eyes are open in the name
Jesus
of Jesus.
Revelation. My eyes are opened in the name of Jesus. My eyes are opened in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord.
Thank you,
in Jesus' mighty name.
Bless you,
Lord. God bless. God bless everyone. I just want to acknowledge a few people. Just give me 2 minutes of your time. Hallelujah. I know when we get into the zone, I know it's sometimes so hard, but I know you've been blessed like I've been blessed. Hallelujah. I see Sister Sylvia. I'm not sure which Sylvia that is, but you're welcome. Hallelujah. God bless you. God bless
Amen.
You.
God bless you too.
Oh, it is Sister Sylvia. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I missed you, my dear. Hallelujah. God bless you.
God bless you. God bless you. God bless you.
It's good to see you this morning. I see Sister Jane. God bless you so much. And I see Sister Ajua as well, was able to join. Now, Sister Ajua has left me. She's in America right now. Hallelujah. Amen. 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 Amen.
Hallelujah. My time has changed, so I couldn't come on. Hallelujah.
So she has no excuse. Hallelujah. Professor Harriet, good morning to you. I'm not sure if you already left, if you're back to the States, but we're glad to have you this morning. God bless you, Minister Magdalene. God bless you. Listen, on Thursday, Minister Juliet will be leading us. Hallelujah. Can we clap for her? Hallelujah. 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 Amen. Thank you, Pastor Clement. Thank you. Hallelujah. I see Professor Arthur, good morning. That's my partner. You know, every time I see his face, I get excited. At least somebody is with me. God bless you, man of God. God bless you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Good morning. Hallelujah. Mama Z, good to see you. Good morning to you. Minister Osas, all the way from Canada, good morning. Good to see you. Sister Fatima made it. God bless you. God bless you. Who else? Have I missed anybody? If I missed you, it's not, but it's by, you know, I'm looking all over. Hallelujah. So forgive me if I missed you this morning, but you are blessed. We love you. Grandma, Pastor Mercy, good morning. I see you as well. Hallelujah. We are coming back tomorrow. Same time, like I said, Pastor Mark will continue. Hallelujah. Invite someone. These are revelations that are being revealed. But guess what? Who the Son made free is free.
He's free indeed. Hallelujah.
I'm free. I need you to declare, I am free in the name of Jesus. I'm blessed in the name of Jesus. It's no longer a part of my me. Poverty has no hold upon my life. Hallelujah. 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 Let's share the grace. Like I said, we're coming back tomorrow. Don't forget. Hallelujah. Please come in the name of Jesus. May the Holy Spirit compel you to come. May you be hungry in the name of Jesus. May you thirst in the name of Jesus for more. Hallelujah. May the glory that has been lost come back in the name of Jesus. Thank you. Let's share the grace. May the grace of our Lord Jesus, the love of God, and the
sweet of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
God bless you.
Thank you. I want you to declare to someone, I am crucified with Christ. I want you to declare to someone, I am crucified with Christ.
I am crucified with Christ.
No more sickness, no more disease.
I am crucified.
Yeah.
I'm a woman.
Celebrate Jesus.